When Joe Biden jets off to Ottawa on Thursday, it won't just be backslapping and jovial banter. There are real problems, challenges, globally, closer to home, causing tension. Let's break down four of them. Here at Roxham Road in Quebec, thousands of migrants are flowing in, and Prime Minister Justin Trudeau is under pressure to cut it off.
On a dépassé notre capacité d'accueil.
Political pressure from the Premier of Quebec, from the federal opposition.
It is his job to close the border.
Trudeau wants the U.S. to take these migrants back and to renegotiate a 20-year-old migration pact. Trudeau wants it extended to include irregular checkpoints. Here's a small problem. This isn't a major U.S. priority. Americans have their own challenges. They could see 3 million migrants this year. That's exponentially more than anything happening at Roxham Road. The U.S. ambassador to Canada says the main issue is not this one rural road in Quebec. Here's what is the main issue, in his view. A historic worldwide surge in human movement driven by conflict, crime, climate disaster, economic desperation.
The critical issue here was to deal with the root causes of irregular migration.
When Canada talks about Roxham Road, the U.S. talks about Haiti. This is what the Americans mean by root causes of migration. The U.S. is pleading with Canada to take a leadership role in stabilizing Haiti, a country beset by political and gang violence, all of it driving migration. Trudeau is skeptical of sending Canadian personnel, police or military, into a complicated, potentially deadly mission.
Outside intervention, as we've done in the past, hasn't worked to create long-term stability for Haiti.
He says Canada can do other things, things the U.S. should emulate, like sanctioning more of the wealthy Haitians funding those street gangs. Fact is, Canada did sign an agreement. Canada promised to be a leader in resettling Francophone migrants, especially Haitians. Watch this space. There could be an announcement this week on more Haitian migration. The U.S. has other concerns about military spending. Remember that Chinese spy balloon incident and the false alarms that followed? Canada and the U.S. have both promised to install better radar, new sensing equipment up in the Arctic, all part of modernizing NORAD. The U.S. wants to get this going with a faster, clearer timetable for spending this money.
We're facing 21st century threats, and 21st century responses cost money.
Watch for some NORAD announcements this week. Then there's trade. In a $1 trillion-a-year relationship, some arguments are inevitable. Canada's annoyed that Biden keeps pushing Buy American policies.
And again, I get criticized for this, but I make no excuses for it. We're going to buy American.
In reality, based on the fine print of what he's proposing, the Canadian officials I talk to aren't so certain these latest moves actually affect Canada very much. But Canadian business says, never mind the fine print. Our companies should have access to U.S. public works contracts.
What we need from leadership is a signal that says, yes, Canada, you are special.
On trade, the U.S. has gripes of its own. Dairy, for example. Americans say Canada's wiggling out of promises under the new NAFTA to import more U.S. cheese. Then there's Bill C-18, a Canadian proposal to make social media giants, American social media giants, pay Canadian media companies for online news. Of course, it won't all be irritants. The leaders will have dinner together. Biden is staying in Ottawa overnight. It's the first time in over 20 years a U.S. president slept in Canada during a bilateral visit. They'll also be making announcements on a mutually shared priority, getting more critical minerals out of the earth, and that's in order to be less reliant on a mutual adversary, China.
We need to make sure that we're keeping Canadians safe and secure into the future.
We're in the strongest position in decades to compete with China or anyone else in the world.
Sometimes history repeats itself. People remember the famous lines from John F. Kennedy's speech to Parliament.
Geography has made us neighbors. History has made us friends.
But people forget there were tensions back then too. In that same famous speech, JFK urged Canada to do more in the world.